This is the news leader, Channel 7 Eyewitness News.
After days of being embedded in a warehouse, the plane that aborted takeoff from Teterboro Airport last week has been moved. And a crackdown on illegal sports betting in New York City nets a whole lot of money and several arrests. Good evening. I'm Charles Perez.
And I'm Sandra Bookman. 4 days after a jet aborted its takeoff and crashed into a warehouse at Teterboro Airport, the wreckage has finally been removed. And at this hour, that plane is making a slow and tedious trek through the streets of several New Jersey communities on the back of a flatbed truck. It's on its way to Harrison, which is roughly about 15 miles away. That's where it's going to be stored and examined. Shannon Sohn joins us live now from NewsCopter 7 over the convoy. Shannon?
Yes, Sandra, 15 miles away, and this trek started 2 hours ago in front of Teterboro Airport, and here we are on Carlton Avenue in Wallington, less than 5 miles from the scene. Now, look at this. What a sight. Imagine coming out of your house and seeing a burnt-up, charred, dinged Challenger running down your street, and that's exactly what people are seeing. You'll see on the left and right of your picture, literally people teeming the streets. At one point, it was going through a main street, Patterson Avenue, as you head through Karlstadt, and there were just people literally walking alongside it. Now, to give you an idea of how slow this convoy is going, look at the rate of the people. They are literally walking slowly right alongside the plane. Now, what it is going to do at this point, as best we can guess, is that it is going to go Carlton Avenue to Jackson Avenue, then cross over Union Avenue and get on to Route 21, finally getting on a major highway that's going to take it down towards Harrison. Now, keep in mind, this has been on Route 17, causing major traffic jams. Every now and then, you'll see lights flashing, people taking pictures of this. Again, 2 hours into this trek, and by Arthur Anderson, my captain, and my best guest, it's going to take another 2 to 3 hours before it finally gets to its final resting place in Harrison. So, really quite a long journey here and an interesting one as well. Now, we want to go to my colleague, Jeff Rawson, who is at Teterboro Airport. He got a front seat view of when this plane was extracted from the building. Jeff?
Shannon, before you go, I want to ask you a quick question. It doesn't look like there's any security down there. Are they actually stopping people from walking up to the airplane? Because there wasn't much of that here today.
Yeah, Jeff, there's not a lot of security here, but what we want to do, let me just take you back outside so we can show you. The crews are actually alongside this, and that is the security that they have. They are checking to make sure that this plane doesn't hit any signs. Keep in mind, it's going quite a roundabout route. It has to consider weight restrictions on the roads, so it's going on very local roadways, and that's how they're keeping people back and what they're doing ahead of it. It's an entire convoy headed by the Bergen County Police Department. They're moving ahead of this to block traffic before the plane gets to an intersection.
No, thank you very much, Shannon. This is also really a crucial day for the NTSB and the FAA. As you know, they have been walking around the plane since the accident happened on Wednesday morning, checking the top of it and the side of it, but only now when they get it to this industrial park and what we assume to be now a warehouse in Harrison, New Jersey, they'll be able to hoist it up and check the underbelly.
If you want to be riding a plane, you don't want to pass by and see one stuck in the building.
So get it out of here.
Get it out of the way.
And today they did, slowly and oh so carefully, pulling the jet out of that warehouse. It is a dangerous job. Fuel still dripping from the broken wings.
It looks like a Universal Studios thing. No. It's kind of surreal.
This crane did the heavy lifting and it turned into a spectacle on Route 46 today. Closed down for hours for this. Neighbors stood in the winter sun just staring.
It looks like a mess.
Minutes later, the plane spins to the left, almost in slow motion. The hole in the warehouse so evident now. And this is our first look at the cockpit and the nose. Smashed in, but amazingly recognizable. NTSB investigators watch as workers climb on top of the jet, tossing bricks to the road, lowering the plane inch by inch onto a flatbed truck.
You get an automobile accident at 25, 30 miles an hour, you have people that die. This thing was doing 100 and something miles an hour when they hit the wall, and everybody survived.
And the car.
Speaking of cars, this is a car, or was a car, though you wouldn't know it, parked in the lot as the plane passed Wednesday.
That's my car.
What kind of car was that?
That's a Toyota 4Runner. Seeing my car like that, if I was inside, you know, it could have been devastating for my family that are here.
Now back to the jet. 4 hours after they started, the plane is finally secure. The flatbed moves down Route 46 as spectators blink. One of those you wouldn't believe it unless you saw it sights.
It's not every day you see a plane in the side of a building being pulled out.
And not every day that you see a plane winding through the streets of what looks like Main Street, USA here in New Jersey, and it is holding up traffic, you should know, on its way to Harrison. Shannon Sohn mentioned a few minutes ago it could take another couple of hours before it reaches the final destination. Quick update on the investigation. As you know, the NTSB has hit a bit of a wall. The pilot says it was a mechanical error. The flight data recorder only yielding about 10 seconds worth of data. They're back to the drawing board now. They've already interviewed the pilot. Pilot says he won't speak publicly for at least a few more days. Live at Teterboro Airport tonight, Jeff Rawson, Channel 7, Eyewitness News.
All right, Jeff, thank you. There has been a twist tonight in that string of deadly jewelry store robberies.
Now, UPN 9 News at 10.
The latest tonight on the jet crash in Teterboro. The plane has now been moved from the warehouse where it crashed, and it was now moved. It's been moved along local streets, leaving neighbors shocked and scared.
I'm very upset watching this aircraft be removed because it didn't have to happen.
Horror, simple horror to see something like that. What a disaster.
The burned out hull of the plane was lifted by crane from the side of the warehouse where it crashed. One of the people watching the spectacle was Rufino Cruz, who works at the warehouse. He had parked his car there Thursday morning and was already on his delivery route when the crash occurred. Today, he came not only to see the plane, but his car.
I know that my car got hit, but I didn't think it was that worse, because my car was the one that got the worst.
Amazingly, there was no loss of life, though one person who was a victim on the ground remains hospitalized in critical condition.
It's used too much, it's too large for where it sits. And as you can see at this end of the airport, there's no buffer zone. There's no place for a plane to stop.
And as the plane makes its way through the local streets, you can see how densely populated the area around the airport really is.
Now that this happened, I mean, people going up and down on both sides is always going to look, it's always going to be in the back of their mind, you know.
The NTSB interviewed the pilot about the crash. He apparently indicated that there may have been a mechanical problem with the plane, but we're told it may be a few more days before the pilot talks publicly about this crash.
Today, the world got its first glimpse of the Pope's...
You're watching New York One. News all weekend.
The corporate jet that crashed near Teterboro Airport last week has finally been removed. Sunday afternoon, crews took away the wreckage for further investigation. On Wednesday, the ACL 600 jet sped past the end of the runway, crossed a major highway, crashing into a warehouse. No one was killed. 20 people were injured. Investigators are still trying to determine the cause of the accident. The pilot of the corporate jet told federal investigators he was forced to abort takeoff at Teterboro Airport. John Kimberling says he hit the brakes and tried to aim the plane where it would cause the least amount of damage.
New York City transit officials say they're investigating.
This is News 12 New Jersey, as local news gets.
4 days after a plane skidded off a Teterboro runway across Route 46 and into a nearby warehouse, the wreckage is now being removed from the building. News 12 New Jersey's Chelsea Sobel is on the scene off Route 46 in Little Ferry. Chelsea, I know the road was closed earlier. Is that still the case?
Yeah, well, Drew, they closed the road about 12:30 this afternoon. They reopened the eastbound side right in back of me, as you can probably see, about 4:30. I'm going to step out of the way. The westbound side near where the wreckage was being removed is still shut down. We actually know that the plane itself was removed, but as you can see, they're still taking care of the area, removing some of the other wreckage. This is a huge deal. Lots of big equipment, a big crane, and believe me, this was definitely the main attraction here today. It was one thing to see the Challenger jet up close, its nose crushed and part of it burned, the result of an aborted takeoff that sent it into this building on Route 46 on Wednesday. But it also left cars like this one charred. And Sunday, with the help of a crane and other equipment, other cars and wreckage were removed from this building. It brought out dozens of nearby residents on a balmy winter's day.
Curiosity. Curious to see it, like everybody else, I think.
It's a nuisance here, you know. This plane landing here and, you know, big plane next to the highway.
Yeah, I mean, never seen this kind of thing before. It is really scary. It is really scary.
All right, just want to mention, Drew, that Route 46 on the westbound side, before you get to that part, I can see it right in front of me. It is open, but only one lane at this point. So just a reminder for folks traveling in the area, you'll probably have some delays. No word exactly where this plane was taken, but I'm sure it was taken somewhere where investigators can actually piece together exactly what and how it happened, the crash, that is, on Wednesday. Back to you.
Yeah, quite an undertaking indeed. Thank you very much. Chelsea Silver reporting from Little Ferry.